Good morning, everyone. My name is Dr. Manisha Ruchandani. I'm second year postgraduate resident at Maharshi Markandeshwar Institute of Medical Science, Mulana. So the topic of my paper that I will be presenting today is diagnostic accuracy of ultrasound and computed tomography in detection of pancreatic tumors. So the solid lesion of pancreas represent a heterogeneous group of entities that can be broadly classified as either neoplastic or non-neoplastic. Neoplastic lesion include pancreatic adenocarcinoma, pancreatic neuroendocrine tumor, solid pseudopapillary tumor, pancreatoblastoma, pancreatic lymphoma, or the metastasis to the pancreas, and rare miscellaneous neoplasm. Non-neoplastic lesion include focal pancreatitis, fatty infiltration replacement, intrapancreatic accessory spleen, congenital anomalies such as prominent pancreatic lobulation and bifid pancreatic tail. So the variety of imaging modalities are available for assessing these solid lesions, including ultrasonography, computed tomography, MRI, and hybrid nuclear imaging such as single photon emission computed tomography and positron emission computed tomography. So, the aim of my study is to assess the accuracy of ultrasound and CT in evaluation of pancreatic tumor and in determining the resectability and prognosis of various pancreatic tumors. So, the methods we have gone through is, this is a prospective study of 50 patients with a pancreatic lesion to evaluate the efficiency of ultrasound and CT in detecting and diagnosing the pancreatic neoplasm. So all the CT examination were performed on 128 slides MD-CT. Out of total 50 cases, the cases with a high suspicion of pancreatic neoplasm based on clinical and laboratory finding positive on CT were 40, and the patient which were positive on ultrasound were 35. So the CT is the most versatile technique for imaging pancreas. It has high diagnostic accuracy for determining the nature of neoplasm. CT has an advantage over ultrasound in evaluation of pancreas, as pancreas being a retroperitoneal may be obscured by a bowel gases, which make it difficult to visualize on ultrasound, but CT has no such limitation. The entire anatomy of pancreas and pathologies can be well delineated by CT. So here is the coronal post-contrast portal phase CT scan shows an isoadenoid tumor in the pancreatic head causing proximal dilatation of CBD and abrupt cutoff. Then we have another axial post-contrast portal phase CT scan shows a double duct sign, the dilatation of CBD and MPD is seen, and we can also see that IHBRDs are present, intrahepatic ductal dilatations is also present. So here is another axial post-contrast portal phase CT shows unresectable adenocarcinoma with vascular invasion and liver metastasis in 72-year-old man present with abdominal pain, weight loss, and jaundice. So here is an axial contrast-enhanced CT image demonstrate a small cyst conjoined in a honeycomb pattern in the pancreatic head and neck. So we can think of serous cyst adenoma. Then we have axial contrast-enhanced CT shows a large complicated cystic lesion in a 54-year-old woman. So we can think of malignant mucinous cyst. So here is the post-contrast portal phase CT scan shows a large tumor in the uncinate process with extensive cystic necrotic degeneration and thick enhancing wall. So we can think of malignant neuroendocrine tumor with cystic necrotic degeneration. Then we have another case, a 53-year-old man present with a general malaise. We can see that the post-contrast arterial phase CT scan shows a heterogeneously hypoattenuated tumor in the pancreatic head containing punctate foci of calcification, and we can also see that a large hypervascular ring enhancing metastasis is seen in segment 6 of the liver. Then a 54-year-old man present with abdominal pain, this is a coronal oblique post-contrast arterial phase, shows the local invasion of pancreatic tail from the lymphomatous infiltration of the spleen, and we can also see that retroperitoneal lymphadenopathy. So this is the second case of secondary lymphoma. This is a pathologically proved metastasis to the pancreas from renal cell carcinoma in asymptomatic 68-year-old woman who had undergone the left nephrectomy. So the post-contrast portal phase CT scan shows a large hypervascular tumor with cystic necrotic degeneration in the pancreatic tail, and these are the vessels, indicate the intratumoral vessels. So, in the PRISM study, out of 40 cases, 31 cases were diagnosed as ductal adenocarcinoma, 6 were diagnosed as cystic neoplasm, 1 with neuroendocrine tumor, 1 with lymphoma, and 1 with metastasis. And rest of the 10 patients were normal on CT and ultrasound. So out of 40 cases, 31 cases were non-resectable due to the local or distant spread of the tumor, and 9 cases were resectable. So the sensitivity and specificity of contrast-enhanced computed tomography in diagnostic of pancreatic tumor is 88.3% and 71.43% respectively. But in case of ultrasound, it's a bit low. The sensitivity is 76% and specificity is 62.5%. So the image finding on ultrasound and CT have a favorable result also. The use of ultrasound is non-invasive, non-ionizing, taking only few minutes, easy to perform and interpret, cost-effective with good repeatability and reliability. But in USG was less sensitivity and specific in detection of pancreatic neoplasm when compared to CT. It was not able to diagnose the small isoechoic solid masses which were diagnosed on contrast-enhanced CT. There was also difficulty in accurate assessment of the local extension and small-sized liver mets. In case of contrast-enhanced CT, it emerged as a better and superior modality in detecting various pancreatic neoplasm, and it is more specific and sensitive when compared to ultrasound. Thank you.